Bonjour world. In today's episode, I'm gonna share with you the best websites I have found this week. And in the second part, I will show you how to record one of the coolest effects I have discovered lately. Let's go. So the first website is a huge amount of work I felt in love with. Let me introduce you, monopo.london. You can see this incredible background that is moving with the mouse move, and then you discover my first favorite effect, this magnifying glass that reveals the translation in Japanese, because Monopo is first a Japanese agency. I love it so much. If you look closely, you will see that what is really cool in this effect is the light distortion. You can see the colors fading away on the border. You can see the red, the green, and the blue channel going a little bit aside. And that's really amazing. I love it. When we scroll, we have this magnetic scroll that is cool, but I don't like too much magnetic scroll. I'm sorry about this. What I like is the transition between two pages. Look at this. Let's play it again. Tac! Doof! So cool. The artistic direction is amazing also. And one thing that you have to notice on this website is when you scroll, you can see on all the images that are rendered with WebGL, obviously, you see that there is a zoom-in effect, distortion effect. I don't really know exactly what's going on, but it's really nice. And on every image, you have this spot that reveals another image behind, and that's pretty cool too. I think there was a special page where it was working so well, but I don't remember exactly well. Where? Wow, this blue and red, it looks like a bird. I don't remember exactly which bird, but let's see. I think it was Friendly Fire's cover. There were a blue bird. Yes, this one, exactly. We have the same color scheme right here. Maybe they took influence of this. I don't know, but look how cute it is. Nature is always a very good way to inspire you. Oh yes, and I found again the other effect, super nice, that I wanted to show you right here. With the other effect, you see the 3D wireframe just behind, and that's amazingly cool, I think. And the last thing from this website I wanted to show you is this. First, the menu effect. That is pretty cool. I like this transition between the three lines that become a cross. I love it. And then look at this. I spoke about it on Twitter, but I have to tell it again on this YouTube video. Here you have these strange hours. You're like, what is this? And when you click, you realize that it's actually a link to the other office of this agency in Japan, in United States, and in London. And yeah, when you click right here, you change the office. That's super, super nice. I love it. I want to click. I want to discover what country this hour is. So that's basically it for the first website. I hope you like it, because now we are going to talk about the second one. And the second one is pretty neat too. The second website is Humble Team. Humble Team, which is an agency from Prague and New York. And the first thing that I want to notice right now is the quality of the assets of this website. All the illustrations are so well, so neat. It's so juicy, so cool. I love it a lot. We're gonna accept the cookies right now, because I realize that a lot of person on my channel are crazy about it, and they are always so pissed off every time I accept cookies like this. So it's for you, my friends. The first effect I want you to notice is this one. When we scroll, look at this. The title of the website, Humble Team, is taking the place of the logo. Look at that. Whew. So cool. I love it. Just for this small effect that seems really easy and simple, there is some computation here. If we inspect the code, I want to show you how it works. Look, you have this here, this block. You have the transform, the scale, and the translate. And you're gonna see when I scroll that the scale and the translate are moving also, like this. So that at the end, the things get its original position. Let's show other good aspect of this website. So you scroll, you discover this text, you discover again amazing animations everywhere, and look how the cards are cool. Look, when you hover, there is this small translation and the illustration is starting to animate. It's really nice. Love it. Let's scroll again. Let's see what they have for us. Enough talk. Yeah, I like it. With the scroll, this title is sliding. And when you are at the bottom, you have this end that come crushing the face. I love it also. Get in touch. Of course, I want to talk to you right now. A few words about your project. I love your website and I am right now shooting a video about it. Say hi to YouTube. And I confirm that I read this. Thank you. Our team will reply soon. I hope so. Thank you very much. I'm waiting for your answer and I hope you will like the video, my friends. Before jumping to the second part, where I'm going to rebuild one effect from scratch, Isabel Moranta, it is on this portfolio that we are going to find the superb effect that we are going to code just after. So, we are here. We have this magnetic effect that I have already recorded on Twitch like 1 month ago. It was really interesting. By the way, if you are not a follower of my Twitch channel, you can leave this video right now. I don't want to talk to you anymore. The website is cool, elegant, but there is not a lot of things to say, except for one effect that I love so much. Look at this over effect. We don't really care about the image. The image is really easy to do, but this rolling 3D effect, it is amazing. And I really wanted to record it because I'm attracted to beautiful things and it's a challenge to do it from scratch. And I think for this effect, there is some JS involved, but we are going to try to do it in full CSS. Let's go. This effect is wonderful and smart. You can go in both directions, normal and reverse. It stimulates a 3D movement that is quite charming. For many technical reasons, I think that this effect has been made with JavaScript. But I think that we can clearly approach 90% of it with just pure CSS. And as I am a CSS lover, I'm gonna try to record it that way to showcase the power of this technology when you mix it with some intelligent tricks. Just before starting the effect, if you are hyped about this kind of content, consider subscribing and press the like button. It helps me a lot and encourages me to keep going. As always, we start by a very simple prototype to confirm that the idea is working in the big lights before going deeper and deeper in the complexity of the effect. Here, for example, we start with a single letter and we are first focusing on the top part that is going up and vanishing, simulating a 3D effect. The key focus point there is to create a good HTML structure that will potentially be able to accept many other letters and, of course, the bottom row letters in the future. By the way, about the letters for this effect, we are gonna use the superb font family Korosu that my friend Emilie has designed. And yeah, thank you again for proposing this font, Emilie. I appreciate it a lot. For this CSS part, it's just a transition on the transform property. We are gonna change the translate Y to make the letter go up, the scale Y to make the letter squeeze and give it the perspective feeling. Changing only these two transform properties is already giving convincing results. Let's now add the bottom letter to achieve the effect on this one letter world. We need to adapt a little bit the HTML and reorganize the positionings with CSS, but nothing too complex. At the beginning, the bottom letter will be translated to the bottom and its scale Y will be set to 0, so that the bottom letter cannot be seen in the initial state. When we hover our word, we want that the bottom letter goes up and grows its scale until reaching the original size. Combining the top and bottom letter effects gives us a pretty nice result. At this point, we are super confident about the rest of the effect. We have this first block working well. We just have to duplicate it and fill it up with other letters. Adding the other blocks was a little bit trickier than expected, and the randomness of the creation process gave us some good alternatives for this effect. For example, putting it on two lines with the movement for all at the same time was giving something pretty cool in my opinion. People who were watching me coding at this time almost wanted me to stop here, so much the effect was pleasant like that. Now that we have a full world on a single line, we have to create the wave effect by adding a small delay on every letter animation.
For example, the animation on the second letter will start shortly after the animation on the first one, and this until we reach the end of the word. I used the power of SCSS to create some for loop to generate this almost automatically. Super neat. And we quickly got the expected results. We could have thought that it was almost over, but there is always a but. When we stopped hovering the word, the reverse effect was absolutely broken. We then had to add some complexity to few pieces of CSS here and there to finally reach the final result, and I'm pretty happy about it. There are many more subtleties in the original effect, and it has been bothering me to the point that offline I tried and reproduced it with pure JavaScript, but for this video we will stop at the CSS part. I will add the link to the source code of the CSS effect in the description if this video reaches 500 likes, so make sure to hit the button, my friends. I hope you enjoyed this video, the featured websites and this crazy effect. If you have other effects, suggestions or websites you would like to be featured in the coming episode, leave a comment below. It was Benjamin Code, see you next week. Ciao.